Orcus, the anti-Pluto dwarf planet. In this video, we will deal with Orcus, a trans-Neptunian celestial body. As the adjective trans-Neptunian says, Orcus is a celestial body that is located beyond the orbit of Neptune in a portion of space known as the Kuiper Belt or Edgeworth Kuiper. The Kuiper Belt, or Edgeworth Kuiper, is an outer region of the solar system that extends from the orbit of planet Neptune, about 30 astronomical units from the Sun, up to 50 astronomical units from the Sun. Its overall shape is somewhat reminiscent of a donut. It takes its name from the astronomers Gerard Kuiper and Kenneth Edgeworth, who in a 1951 article hypothesized the presence of objects beyond Neptune's orbit, later known as trans-Neptunian objects, or TNOs. Unlike the main asteroid belt between the orbits of Mars and Jupiter, essentially composed of rocky bodies, the Kuiper Belt is composed of small icy bodies, mainly water ice, ammonia, and methane, whose orbits are arranged on the plane of the ecliptic, which is the same plane on which the orbits of the planets also lie. The presence of Neptune has a profound effect on the structure of the Kuiper Belt due to orbital resonances. An orbital resonance occurs when two orbiting bodies have periods of revolution such that their relationship can be expressed in fractions of small whole numbers. For example, Pluto and Neptune are in 2-3 orbital resonance. This means that every 3 revolutions of Neptune around the Sun, Pluto makes 2. Over a period of time comparable to the age of the solar system, it can happen that Neptune's gravity destabilizes the orbits of objects in orbital resonance, sending them into the inner solar system, or pushing them outwards, towards interstellar space. The gravitational influence of Neptune means that there are pronounced gaps in the current structure of the belt, that is, areas in which there are very few or no objects. These are precisely zones of gravitational instability produced by orbital resonances. Over 2,000 Kuiper Belt objects, or KBOs, have been discovered in the belt, and it is thought that there may be over 100,000 with a diameter greater than 100 kilometers, and that the total mass of all objects in the Kuiper Belt could be a tenth or even 1/100th of the land mass. In total, there may be millions of celestial bodies in the Kuiper Belt. Kuiper Belt objects can be roughly divided into classical and resonant. In the first case, classical Kuiper Belt, the objects can maintain their orbits unchanged over time. Here we find out about 2/3 of the KBOs observed to date. 15,760, 1992 Cube-1, the first modern KBO discovered, Pluto and Charon apart, is considered the prototype of this group, and from it derives the term Cubewani, a term that indicates the classical KBOs and which is the phonetic translation of the English acronym QB1OS, Cubewanos. According to an IAU guideline, the name to be given to classical KBOs is that of mythological beings associated with creation. The classical KBOs are mainly concentrated in two areas, with orbital resonance with Neptune 2-3 and 1-2. Between 42 and 48 astronomical units from the Sun, where the gravitational influence of Neptune is negligible. The classical Kuiper Belt appears to be composed of two different populations. The first, known as the dynamically cold population, is composed of objects with orbits very similar to those of the planets, i.e. almost circular, with an orbital eccentricity less than 0.1, and orbital inclinations not exceeding 10 degrees. The second, the dynamically hot population, has much more inclined orbits than the ecliptic, up to 30 degrees. The two populations were named in this way not because of a difference in temperature, but because of the analogy with the particles of a gas, which increase their relative velocity with temperature. The hot population is believed to have formed near Jupiter and ejected by the movements and gravitational interactions of the gas giants. Furthermore, the cold population is believed to have formed more or less in its current position, although it may have been flung outwards later, during the migration of Neptune, described by the NISM model, which owes its name to the Observatoire de la Côte d'Azur of Nice, where it was formulated. The Nice model is a physical model that stimulates the dynamic evolution of the solar system in the phases immediately following its formation. And according to it, Neptune and Uranus were originally much closer to the Sun than they are today. Would you have liked to see this important movement in the evolution of the solar system? Write it in the comments. As for the resonant Kuiper belt objects, they are in orbital resonance with Neptune. Objects in resonance 2 to 3 with Neptune have a semi-major axis of about 39.4 AU, and about 200 of this type are known, including Pluto and its moons, prototype of the members of this class known as Plutinos. Plutinos have high orbital eccentricity, suggesting that they did not originate in their current positions, but were hurled towards the outer solar system by the migration of Neptune. IAU guidelines dictate that all the Plutinos must, like Pluto, be named after deities associated with the underworld. The 1-2 orbital resonance zone, whose objects complete one orbit while Neptune makes two and have half axes greater than around 47.7 AU, is sparsely populated. Members of this class are known as Tutini. There are other resonances with ratios 3-4, 3-5, 4-7, and 2-5. Neptune also has a number of Trojan asteroids occupying its Lagrangian points L4 and L5. These are often in a 1-1 resonance with Neptune and have generally stable orbits. The largest body in the Kuiper belt is Pluto, and the most massive is the dwarf planet Eris, discovered in 2005, although some scientists consider Eris to be part of the diffuse disk rather than the Kuiper belt. Since the year 2000, other objects of considerable size have been found. 50,000 Quoar discovered in 2002, half the size of Pluto and larger than Ceres, the largest of the traditional asteroids. The exact classification of these objects is unclear, as they are likely very different from the innermost asteroids. Some satellites of the planets of the solar system appear to come from the Kuiper belt, such as Triton, the largest of Neptune's moons, and the Saturnian moon Phoebe. It is believed that short-period comets, that is, those that take less than 200 years to travel their orbit around the Sun, come from the Kuiper belt. In addition to the classic and resonant Kuiper belt objects, we should also mention the diffuse disk, a sparsely populated region, the innermost part of which overlaps the Kuiper belt, and which extends up to 100 AU from the Sun and beyond. Unlike what happens to the objects of the innermost Kuiper belt that we have spoken about now, the objects of the diffuse disk travel in a very elliptical and often very inclined orbits with respect to the ecliptic. Most models of solar system formation show that both KBOs and disk objects were part of a belt of primordial comets, and that subsequent gravitational interactions, particularly with Neptune, sent these objects outward in some stable orbits, KBOs, and others in unstable orbits, forming the diffuse disk. Among the objects of the Kuiper belt, although present mainly in its outermost part, there are also the detached objects, whose orbit is almost entirely included between 40 and 50 astronomical units from the Sun. Given their gigantic distance from Neptune, it is unlikely that these objects will suffer the gravitational perturbations. An example of a detached Kuiper belt object is SEDNA, whose orbit has a perihelion at 76 astronomical units from the Sun and aphelion at about 1,200 astronomical units from our star. The Centauri asteroids deserve a separate mention. Their orbits extend between Jupiter and Neptune and undergo their intense gravitational attraction. Many of them, due to these gravitational perturbations, end up being ejected from the solar system or pushed towards the innermost areas of the solar system, where they become comets or crash into the Sun and planets. Be sure to join the channel, leave us a like, and click on the bell. You will help us to make products of even higher quality. Among the many celestial bodies of the Kuiper belt, we find Orcus, discovered on February 17, 2004, by Michael E. Brown of the California Institute of Technology, Chad Trujillo of the Gemini Telescopes, and David Lincoln Rabinowitz of Yale University. But the celestial body was later identified in some photographic images in the archive dating back to December 8, 1951. Possessing a size and an orbit similar to that of Pluto, Orcus has been given the name of a deity of the underworld. In accordance with the astronomical naming conventions of the International Astronomical Union, the discoverer suggested the name Orcus, which was approved and published on November 22, 2004. Orcus is both an alternate name for the Greek deity Hades and an abstract god of the death in Roman mythology. Orcus is a large Plutino and takes 247 years to travel its orbit around the Sun. Although Orcus has an orbital period very similar to that of Pluto, it has a different orientation. Thanks to 1951 images from the Siding Spring Observatory in Australia and 1954 from Palomar Sky Survey, it was possible to determine that the distance of Orcus from the Sun varies between 30.9 astronomical units and 48.1 astronomical units. Orcus's orbit is inclined by 20.6 degrees on the ecliptic, more than that of Pluto, which is about 17 degrees. The last passage in aphelion of Orcus took place in 1989, while the next passage in perihelion will take place in 2113. Would you like to visit Orcus? Write it in the comments. Due to its 2-3 residence with Neptune, Orcus and Pluto are in opposite positions. For this reason, Orcus is also known as the Anti-Pluto. Every 14,000 years, Orcus comes within 18 astronomical units of Neptune. The apparent magnitude of the dwarf planet is equal to 19.1, which is roughly equivalent to that of 50,000 Kuiper. In any case, it is a value well below the threshold of visibility to the naked eye, which is around the sixth magnitude. Assuming an albedo of 0.09, Trujillo estimates its diameter to be approximately 1,600 kilometers. Recall that the albedo represents the fraction of incident solar radiation reflected from the surface of a celestial body in all directions. Orcus would therefore be among the largest objects in the Kuiper Belt so far, along with Eris, Pluto, Makemake, Haumea, Sedna, and Gongong. According to observations in the infrared band made by the four very large telescopes in Chile of the European Southern Observatory with a diameter of 8 meters, on the surface of Orcus there would be water ice and carbon residues. Observations made by the Hubble Space Telescope from November 13, 2005 onwards made it possible to discover a satellite orbiting around Orcus. The discovery was made by Mike Brown. The discovery of the Orcus satellite was reported by the International Astronomical Union on February 22, 2007. The satellite thus discovered was initially indicated with the provisional designation S2005-904821. Later, it was given the official designation of Vanth as the Etruscan deity of the underworld. Its orbit is nearly circular, with an orbital eccentricity of 0.0036, an orbital period of 9.53 days, and a distance of just 8,980 plus or minus 20 kilometers from Orcus. It also has a spectrum very similar to Orcus, a characteristic that can determine its surface structure. In 2005, the satellite was estimated to be separated of 0.25 arc seconds from Orcus, with a magnitude difference of 2.7 plus or minus 1. Assuming an albedo similar to that of the planet, the magnitude suggested a diameter of about 250 kilometers, equal to about one quarter, one third of the diameter of Orcus.